Hey everyone, this is Sanjay here. In this video, I will show you a tool called Venti. Many of you might already know this, but I'm making this video for those who don't know about Venti. Let's quickly go to the Venti website. Just search for Venti. This is the official site for the Venti. It is an open source tool which will run in both Windows and Linux as of now. As you can see here, Venti is an open source tool to create a bootable USB. We can just throw in the ISO or WAM or the IMG file and also even virtual hard disk into the USB. It will just boot into the image or virtual hard disk, whichever you might put in the USB. As of the time of filming this video, there are 550 plus ISOs are supported and more than 90% distros in DistroWatch are supported. When you install Venti, it will take around 30 megabytes as a separate partition for it to install, and the rest we can use for holding an image, or we can use it for whatever purpose we need. And these are the features for Venti. I'm not going to read this. You can read this yourself by visiting venti.net. Let us quickly download this. Let's head over to the downloads tab, and right now I am using Windows. I click on Windows and it takes to the GitHub page for Venti. I'm going to download the latest release, windows.zip 1.0.22 windows.zip, and I'm going to open it. I'm going to just drag and drop it to the desktop. Let's just open the Venti folder, and here you can see the Venti to disk.exe file. I have already plugged in an SD card named SDHC. It is an old camera card and I will just use it for Venti. Let's start installing Venti onto the memory card. Just run the Venti to exe. As you can see here, it will show the memory card or USB flash drive, any other removable disk here. I am using a card reader to read the memory cards, so I will select this and click install. It will show some warning, all the data will be erased in your disk. Hit S and it will double check, and hit S and it will show Venti has been successfully installed to the device. Hit OK, close it. Also, there is an option to change the partition style. If your motherboard has an MBR, you can choose MBR. If your motherboard has an UEFI, you should choose GTP, because MBR is obsolete since it was last released in 2011, maybe before that. But nowadays GTP is the standard now, so go with the GTP. If you use MBR, some of the Windows ISO images will not work. Other than that, every other Linux image seems to work for me. If you are using Venti, just go with the GTP partition style, because when I tried in MBR, I can't boot into the Windows ISO because the MBR is obsolete. And also, you can find the options for secure boot support. If you have a secure boot, you can also add a secure boot support. Just clicking on secure boot support, and then you can select your device and you can install Venti. As you can see here, I have an MBR. I need to convert into GTP, so GTP is selected and I'm going to update it. If you are installing for the first time, just click on install. As you can see here, it is successfully completed. The ISO in the Venti partition is unaffected. And when you go back to the computer, you can see our disk renamed as Venti. You should not change the name of this disk, and you can just copy and paste the ISO image onto this partition. Let's head over to the disk management tool, which is built into the Windows disk management, and here it will show the memory card which I have installed the Venti. This is an EFI partition which is used by Venti. It takes around only 32 megabytes of the space. Rest of that we can use it for ISO, or you can use it as a regular USB. You can save files, videos, anything you need. And if you place a ISO image, you can boot right from it by using Venti. Let's quickly throw in an ISO image of Linux Mint into the partition, and I will show you how it works. I have grabbed a copy of Linux Mint from the Linux Mint website, and I will quickly throw that in. This is just a class 4 card, so we can't expect much speed from this card. So I am going to speed this one up. I have copied the Linux Mint ISO onto the USB which I have installed Ventoy. Let's close this and shut the Windows down and we can boot it from the Ventoy USB. I'm going to shut down the system. And this is the USB card reader which I'm going to use. And this memory card has the Ventoy installed in that. I'm going to switch to the boot menu. As you can see here, let me quickly zoom in. This is the UEFI partition, it contains the Ventoy, and I'm going to hit enter. As you can see here, this is the Ventoy boot screen, and this is the ISO which I placed in the empty partition of the Ventoy USB, and I'm going to hit enter to boot into the Linux Mint ISO. As you can see here, shows the grub menu to choose from. I'm going to start the Linux Mint. As you can see here, we have successfully booted into the Linux Mint by using the Ventoy tool. A huge thanks to the Ventoy developers. This tool is frequently updated for different ISOs. You can see the change log for the Ventoy tool to get an idea about what distros are supported. And they have a cute documentation in which they have explained what is going on with each releases. Hope you get a knowledge about a tool which is helpful for installing various distributions of Linux and installing Windows. Previously I was using the Rufus for flashing Windows and Linux, and this is a big game changer for me. Because of this, I will just copy and paste the ISO or image file and just flash it into the hard disk of the system. Hope you find this tool useful for you, and if you have enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you like my content, hit the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching.